Good morning, students. I am Dr. Pooja Shukla, and I'll be taking the subject Effective Technical Communication. Today, we'll be going into the detailed orientation of the subject and the flow of the lectures that will be taken online. So, you are well aware about the teaching scheme, yet I'll repeat it for you. It is a 3-credit course which has 2 lectures and 1 lab per week. Now, the examination or the evaluation scheme is 70 marks for end semester, 30 marks for mid semester, 30 marks for practicals, and 20 marks for practical assignment. So it adds on to 150 marks in total for the subject Effective Technical Communication. So in total, we have 6 units, and each unit has different subtopics. So unit number 1 is dynamics of communication, definition and process. That is definition and process of communication. So we'll be learning what is communication, how many types of communication are there, what is the entire process that will take place. Then there'll be technical aspects like kinesics, proxemics, paralinguistic features, interpersonal and intercultural communication in today's world. So these are all related to communication. There are actually different aspects of what communication is, whether it be written or oral. So unit number 2 is technical writing. So here we'll be given technical formats that we need to use for writing and describing things. As you all know that writing is very important, because when you speak, your words would vanish. But when you write, you give it a concrete form. So what will be covered in technical writing? It would be report writing, technical proposal, technical description, letters, especially business letters or more formal kind of letters, agenda of meeting, minutes of meeting, and most importantly, resume writing. Unit 3 will cover technical communication. As you see, unit 2 was written communication. So this is more of the oral part of communication. That is public speaking, group discussion, presentation strategies, interview skills, negotiation skills, creative thinking and communication. Unit 4, ethics in engineering. Why is it necessary to have engineering in any field? And then how ethics would be important for especially engineering and engineering branches. The scope of engineering ethics, accepting and sharing responsibilities, responsible professionals and ethical corporations, resolving dilemmas, ethical dilemmas, and making moral choices. Unit 5 is very important because it has got etiquettes and manners. So how do we behave when you talk over the phone? How do you behave when you talk in person? How do we need to respect somebody's privacy? Sometimes it is very good to say no to somebody. So how do we say no? And most importantly, where we all need a little bit of training and polishing is time management. And unit number 6 is self-development and assessment. So we should know where we started and how much we have grown. So there are different factors which will help you understand whether you have developed or not, or where do you need to polish yourself to develop yourself in terms of being a professional. So if you see, we have mentioned in the evaluation scheme that we need to do a Coursera course, and then there are 2 assignments for it. Now please understand, 30 marks means 20 marks for the completion of the Coursera course and submission of certificate, and 10 marks for your Viva. I repeat, 20 marks for completion and submission of the certificate of a Coursera course, and 10 marks for Viva, and then there are 2 assignments. Now, if you wish, you can note this down. The Coursera course title is Communication Skills for Engineers. Communication Skills for Engineers. This you will get on the Coursera website. This is a Coursera course. It has 3 sub-courses, oral communication, interpersonal communication, and writing skills. we need to complete the all the three of them. Now, assignment number one is a book review. There are certain books mentioned in the syllabus itself. Jyoti has already given us a list of books, and we are supposed to select a book from there only. I'll be sharing the syllabus in the e-content, and you'll get the syllabus from there, and you can have a look at the list of books that are provided over there. You'll be given guidelines for preparing the book review. The format and instructions will be given to you and will also be uploaded in the e-content portion of the college portal. Assignment 2 is resume writing. Here also will be giving you a format and will give you a step-wise instruction to prepare it and submit it. Now the flow of the lecture. Every lecture, the flow would remain the same. Flow means how do we go about in the lecture? That means how will we start the lecture? What things will happen in between? And how do we work on the assignments in the writing part? So first thing, which is very important, you need to maintain a book for this subject. Why a book? So that you can note down the important points. Wherever it is told that this is important, please keep in mind. So you can make a note of it. One. Two, assignments. Most will be preferring assignments handwritten. That is, you will write it down and then you will convert it into a PDF and give it to us. We want handwritten assignments. We don't want copy pasting in the assignment part. So that's why the book is important. You are free to maintain a book or file pages, but you need to maintain it. Whenever you are asked to submit something, you have to click a picture, turn it into a PDF and submit it to the faculty. That is why it is required. So whatever you are comfortable, either a book or a file page, but things should not go missing, right? That is why we'll require a book. Now, whenever the lecture starts, we will have one of you from the class giving the opening remarks. By opening remarks, I mean that one of the student would give an outline of what is to be taught or what topics will be covered in that particular lecture. So it is like a briefing that you are supposed to give to your fellow classmates. Do not worry, by the time we come to the end of this presentation, for the first 15 lectures, we've already given somebody's name. So everybody's turn would come. For the opening remark part, at least everybody's turn would come once. Now in the next 15 minutes, what we will do is, we'll be discussing the topics. We'll be discussing the topics for that particular lecture. And after 15 minutes, there will be a question. Now for answering that question, one student's name will be given. I'll be giving you beforehand, like for tomorrow's lecture, who is opening, who'd be answering question one is already decided and I'll be giving it. Do not worry, right now we have just set it up for 15 lectures. Then the next 15 lecture information will be shared with you pre-hand. Way before time, I'll be sharing. So, question number one. Why this question? Because if I ask a question, I'd come to understand whether we've been listening or not, whether we've understood what has been taught or not. So, 3 minutes. Then 15 minutes of discussion, then one question, 5 minutes of discussion on the question, how you'll answer and all. Then again, 15 minutes of discussion and explanation of the topic, then one more question. So question number two would be assigned to a second student. And then 10 minutes of again discussion and completing the lecture. Now, after that, we will have a small 5 to 10 minute session on doubt solving, recalling the main portions of the lecture. So what are the topics that we did and what are the important terms that we need to remember? And then if there are any doubts, so we'll have a little doubt solving session after every lecture. So we are very clear when we move on to lecture number, from lecture 2 to lecture 3, that lecture 2 was very clear. We are now don't have any doubts in lecture 2, and then we move on to lecture 3. After that, we have a 5-minute quiz. A 5-minute quiz. Now, at the end of every session, we will be having a quiz that is compulsory to attend. It carries 5 marks, and it would be a part of your continuous semester evaluation. Please understand, this quiz will be held after every lecture. And after every lecture, we have a quiz. The quiz carries 5 marks. It could be either an MCQ quiz, or it would be a true or false, fill in the blank type of a quiz. It's an objective quiz, which is compulsory to attend, because it will give you marks. It will be considered in your markings whenever we culminate the entire quiz that we take for the whole subject, every lecture, and then we'll give some marks for it. It's important to attempt the quiz. 3 to 4 minutes for attendance, and at the end, 3 minutes will be given for closing remarks or summing up. Now, in the closing remarks, it is the student who will close the session, so that whatever is done, once I will recall, that is in the 10 minute of the Q&A, doubt solving and recalling session, the faculty, or that is I, who would be telling that these are the points. And towards the very end of the lecture, it would be one of you who would be closing it up, and will be talking to us about what is happening and what has happened, and these are the important things that we need to remember from the lecture. As I said, we'll be having quizzes. Quizzes at the end of each and every session. Every lecture will end with a quiz. Now, this quiz would be in the form of a Google form. The Google link will be sent to you in the chat box when the quiz begins, and only 5 minutes will be given. It's a time has already been set for the quiz. It will automatically close within 5 minutes. So this is a Google form that you need to fill up. The quiz has been prepared. You need to enter a few details like your name, your enrollment number, and the class. Classes, EC1, EC2, EC3, whatever class you belong to, that you need to note. These are the only three things that you need to type. The rest, you just need to click and select the options that are given to you. You need to click and select the options that are given to you. So it would be an objective type, 5 questions, option given, you pick it and you click it, right? So these quizzes are important because, as I said, it would be mapped with your continuous evaluation scheme, that is the CSE. You will be given marks for it. It would be culminate the entire section of quizzes that we have taken, and we will work on it in that way. Now, as I said, somebody will give an opening remark, somebody will give a closing remark, right? So if you can see your name, and you can see who gives the opening remarks and closing remarks where. Now, whoever is supposed to give the opening remarks gets in touch with me a day before the lecture and will get information of what are we going to do in that particular lecture. Closing remarks, you will be able to give closing remarks as and when the lecture comes to an end, because you are supposed to paraphrase, or you are supposed to just conclude the whole session. So you listen to the session, you need the closing remark, you don't need to talk to me in that case. You need to attend the class and you need to do it. For opening remarks, one day before, you need to talk to me or get in touch with me and get to know what would be in that particular session. Now remember, this is lecture one, that's why it starts from lecture two, three, four, that way. So there is no confusion, this is lecture one. So tomorrow would be lecture two. So it would be Mahek Ajudia would be giving the opening remarks, and Vatsal Hirpara would be closing the session. It would be a ritual for all the lectures. I will be sharing the sheet with you as well. Now, as I said, there would be two questions in the session, in our session flow. So you can see it would be Ishan would be answering question one and Manthan question two. Now, these people would be answering inevitably, but apart from that, randomly also other students would be asked to answer question one and two. So it means that it is not only his duty or her duty to answer the question. Randomly, we may ask some other student also to share their views on the same question. So for these two people, it is compulsory. For the rest of us, it is necessary. So anytime I may ask one of you, take your name from the attendance sheet and say, yes, what are your views on this question? So when we see the discussion is happening, that is how we will work. So this information, first table shows you who will be opening the sessions and who will be closing the sessions. That is lecture wise. As this is lecture one, we have started from lecture two onwards, till 15 lecture. As I said, right now I'm sharing the information for lecture 15. So the concerned people can take a note of these things. I'll wait a few minutes. By the time you take a note of it, just write it down. I'll be sharing this slide as well, so don't worry about it. But those who have those who have been assigned to give opening remarks tomorrow or in the next week can just quickly note it down. So this is the information for opening remarks and closing remarks. Now, this is the table for answering questions. I'll keep this table as it is. You can take a quick note of it as well. So which lecture and which question number? It's like clearly mentioned to us which lecture, which question number. Here you can see the questions have been assigned till lecture 8, and on the next slide we have it till lecture 15. So you can have a quick note down of the lecture number and the question number that you need to answer. As I've mentioned, here we have just got till enrollment number 103. Other people will be asked randomly after that. We'll have maybe a random session where somebody's name is called out and you have to also answer the question. I hope you have taken a note of the important details. I hope you have taken a note of the important details. Do we have any doubts pertaining to the things that have been said? I'll repeat it once again. We need to maintain a book or file pages, whatever is comfortable to you, but we need things whenever you are asked to share the work that you have done, you are supposed to submit it. That's why whatever is comfortable, I would prefer a book because pages do not go missing in case of books. And if you have file papers, maintain a file. So I have shared my contact number and WhatsApp number in the chat box with you. You can always drop a WhatsApp message so that you know about what is happening and how we are supposed to open up. Now remember, when I say opening remarks, it means that you are not supposed to disclose or teach the whole thing, but you are supposed to give pointers. For example, today we'll start with unit number one. Our topic for today is this. The topic will cover this many sub-points. That's it. You are not supposed to elaborate the whole thing. You are just supposed to give pointers. Pointers means small points that this is the unit that we are doing. And in that unit, this is the subtopic. And in this subtopic, these are the different points that will be covered. I hope I'm making myself clear. Do we have any other doubts? The session will begin with the student or your classmate talking about us, what will be in the lecture, and it will end with the student, your classmate, will be telling us what we did in the lecture, so that a whole circle completes. Do we have any doubts regarding this? The details for the Coursera course and the assignments and the formats will be shared to you in your lab sessions. No doubts, right? So nobody has any doubts for today? Okay, fine. So for today, what we will do is, before we start any lecture, before every lecture, I'll be giving you a few words. Or maybe words that are important for that particular topic that we are teaching. We're not supposed to work on anything. We're supposed to look at the words, find their meanings, and think about them, how they'd be related in the topic that we are taking. So, 2 minutes to find yourself with a pen or and a book to note down what is being said. and the attendance marking part would be, I'd be taking your name, you have to type a yes in the chat box. Yeah, whenever there's attendance taking, I'll call out your name, you type a yes in the chat box. So that it's easier to mark attendance. So please note down. I hope now you are ready with the pen and the book. So word number one is communication. Word one is communication. The second word is source. Or sender. Communication, source, oblique, sender. Word three would be encode. Word number three is encode. Word number four is channel or medium. Word number four is channel or medium. Word number five is receiver. Word number five is receiver. Word number six is decode. Word number six is decode. And the last word, word number seven, is feedback. I'll repeat the list once. Communication, source or sender, encode, channel or medium, receive or receiver, decode, and feedback. These are the seven words on which you have to work on. Work on in the sense you have to find the meaning. How can these words be used in sentences? Can find the meaning and how these words can be used in sentences. Whatever you work is assigned to you, please do it in the same book that you make for the subject, etc. Whatever work is assigned to you, that is, even if you are assigned to find meanings of the words, use them in different kind of sentences, write it down and note it down in the same book that you prepare for the subject. Don't write it anywhere else. I hope I am clear with the instructions. Do we have any doubts with the instruction for this vocabulary part, vocab part? Okay, I don't have doubts for this session. The syllabus as well as this PPT will be uploaded in the e-content right after this lecture. So if you have missed marking your name of when you are answering the opening remark or when you are talking about the questions and all, you can get a look from there. The PPT as well as the detailed syllabus is there. The most important thing in the detailed syllabus is the reference book. We don't have textbooks, we have reference books. So there's a list given by GTU which you can refer to. You may find the related information on internet as well, but there are certain, like the topics are quite wide, but what we are covering is limited. So that's why the reference book, you may search for the reference book online. If you are unable to get it, please let me know. I'll see how we can work that reference book part out as well. Now there's a special mentioning of a link, especially for unit number 4. It is mentioned in the syllabus itself. We're supposed to study case studies. So real life incidences which have happened or incidences which may occur, and how do we come to a solution to it? As I said, we have an entire unit on ethics. So you can refer to the link which is already provided in the syllabus. It has been provided by GTU, and that's the link that we are going to use in case you want to explore how things work. So that is one of the ways you can do. That is the link that you can explore. It is given or provided in the list itself. As I said, the books that we are supposed to review as a part of our assignment are already provided by GTU. So you can also go through that list, and I'll be asking you to tell me the name of the book that you wish to do for your assignment in your lab sessions. So what I suggest is you go through the list, you have a look at it. Book review means you have to read the book. So if something interests you from the list, you are supposed to take that up. Otherwise, something you have to take, right? So I suggest you go through the list before the lab sessions in this week so that we can easily identify what would work for you and what would you like to work on. And formats for, don't be in a hurry to do the assignments. Format for everything will be provided and explained to you. Fine. So I hope we all have a clarity on how the lectures will work, what the syllabus is, and what kind of assignments are there. You need to try and complete the Coursera course. There's a deadline to it. That is the 30th of July. Today is the 22nd of June. 30th of July, you need to complete. Try and complete the Coursera course that is mentioned in the syllabus. The title, I'll repeat if you do not remember and you wish to write, I'll repeat, the title of the course is Communication Skills for Engineers. Communication Skills for Engineers. The deadline is 30th July 2020. That's almost a month and 10 days or so. So we're trying to complete that course by 30th of July, and you need to submit a certificate of completion. So now I'm just calling out your name. We'll be taking the attendance. As we see, there is no doubt as of now. So I'll call out your name. You just type a yes in the chat box, so it's easier for us to mark attendance. So it is Mahek. Then we have got Vrunda. Juzar. रवि, रवि भट्ट। देन विश्वराज सिंह, वासु कुमार, हिमांग ध्रुव, विश्वा, नीरव, नीरव गेलानी, विधि, ब्रिज, ब्रिज बुधानी, वत्सल, सॉरी आदित्य, आई मिस्ड योर नेम, आदित्य गोरस्या, ईशान, मंथन, जीनल कंसाग्रा, वासु, मोहम्मद फैज, मोहम्मद अनस, खोखर, कृपाली खूट, अंजन कोरडिया, रमेश कुमार, शुचि कुंडालिया, कानन कुनपरा, मिताली ललानी, जय मकवाना, भाविन मुवालिया, भाविन मुवालिया, भौतिक नमेरा, भौतिक राज, दर्शिल नथानी, पैनी परमार, जय परमार, अलविश पीपलिया, रिया पोपट, हर्षिल शेखड़ा, हर्षिल, संजय सिद्धपुरा, राज सोनी, गौरव तन्ना, अवनी तारपरा, पूजन वर्तिका ठक्कर, नैसर्गी, हिमाली वेकरिया, यश, केविन, केयू, शुभम, शुभम गोस्वामी, कुंज, देवेन, नेहल, जय प्रजापति, जय अदिति शाह, जस्ट कॉल आउट द एब्सेंट नंबर्स इन केस यू हैव मिस्ड योर नंबर. रवि भट्ट, एनरोलमेंट नंबर 9. भौतिक नमेरा, एनरोलमेंट नंबर 67. एंड जय प्रजापति, एनरोलमेंट नंबर 134. Not been, nobody has been missed out. Who is the class representative? Who is the CR of the class? Anjan. Anjan and Ria. I've just noted down your names for in case if things are required to be told through you. Right, so we're ending today's lecture on this note over here. So tomorrow we'll be starting with Unit 1, Topic 1. Right, so I think Mehak should drop a message on what is going to be happening. Right, and as soon as this lecture comes to an end, I'll be updating in the e-content of our portal from where you can get the syllabus and you can start working on it. So, thank you, class. Thank you, everyone, for joining the session.